making a niche for yourself, when you're making a career for yourself, when you are studying, onset is between 15 to 25 years of age. And the prevalence is 1%. So when I think of 1% prevalence, I'm thinking my batch is of 100 students, there's a likelihood that one of them could have schizophrenia. And that's what I keep telling my students. I keep telling them, if at all you start having symptoms which are unusual, or you see these symptoms in some of your classmates or colleagues, it's unusual, or your family members, it's unusual, do seek help. Do ask for help. I mean, it might not be anything. Do ask. Thinking of prevalence as suicide as well. I mean, my MBBS days, none of my, when you're doing MBBS, no one talks to each other about mental illness. If you have mental illness as well, you don't tell it to others because there's a lot of stigma. After I did my psychiatry, people came to know I'm a psychiatrist. I got to know there were two students in my class, or one student from my senior, one student my junior, who developed schizophrenia, who had schizophrenia, who were on treatment, but they never disclosed it. Two of my classmates committed suicide, completed suicide, from a batch of 150. So that was, those are very damning statistics from a medical college. So people think that higher education is a preventative step against mental illness. All that is false. It's a biological illness, it can happen to anyone. When you see somebody who is negative, who is withdrawn, when you see a sudden change in their personality, somebody who is hardworking, somebody who is doing very well, suddenly starts withdrawing, stops talking to people, stops going out, started closing doors and windows and staying inside the room, stop interacting with others, one needs to be worried. Mostly under-recognized and long DUP. DUP stands for duration of untreated psychosis. It's very, very long. Duration of untreated illness is very long for schizophrenia because it's never picked up. And it's one of the most frightening experiences that we have. I mainly presented these three slides because, I forgot this one. Drug and alcohol sometimes we neglect, but we need to know about. There are two kinds of illnesses. One is young onset and late onset. So people who are young can develop it as part of their experience, behavior, and wanting to try other things. Those are the kind of people who start with alcohol, go to cannabis, cocaine, heroin, and so on. And I think it's not right to say that it doesn't exist in our campus. I mean, it's there everywhere. We are not immune from it. But there's something called late onset drug use as well. Alcohol use sometimes can start in people, at a later age. And that is something that we need to be aware of. People would have views that, broken families or poor parenting and everything can cause drug abuse. It's not quite true. A lot of drug abuse has genetic implications or genetic pointers. So if you are genetically predisposed to develop alcoholism, chances are that you're more likely to develop alcoholism as well. If you have a family history of alcoholism and somebody else doesn't, chances are when you have an alcohol, you might feel a different effect to somebody who doesn't have a genetic risk. Chances are if you have a family history, when you give up alcohol, it's a lot more difficult for you to give up alcohol than somebody who doesn't have a family history or genetic risk. So I want you to be aware of that. Once you look at it as an illness, then you stop bringing morality into question. When you start talking about alcohol as a moral illness, I think that's when conflicts occur. You call somebody bad because they're an alcoholic, that's when problem occurs. It's an illness, it's a biological illness.